Welcome to the Abyss. I'm Jacqueline, and today we're explaining how the tides work. Let's dive in. The consistent ebb and flow of the tides is created by the gravitational effect of the sun and the moon on the Earth. Just like the Earth, all bodies of mass exert a gravitational field, and that field is proportional to its size. So the sun, being much larger than the moon, has a much stronger gravitational force. However, the effect of gravity on another body is also dependent on the distance. The moon, being closer, is the dominant impact on Earth and consequently the tides. In fact, the gravitational effect of the moon on the Earth is approximately twice that of the sun. The moon causes the tides because it creates a gravitational differential. This is referred to as the tidal force. The moon exerts a gravitational force on the Earth, but as I already mentioned, this force is affected by distance. This means that areas on the Earth's surface that are close to the moon experience a greater gravitational pull than areas that are farther away. Since the ocean sits on top of the Earth, the force it actually feels is the difference between the gravitational force at the surface of the Earth and the force felt at the center of the Earth. At areas 90 degrees from the moon, this differential results in a downward force, whereas on the side of the Earth in line with the moon, the differential results in an outward force. Overall, this gravitational differential results in an ellipsis, with the net force pushing the water towards the Earth-Moon line. This force is very minute. However, over a large distance, such as the surface of the ocean, this force accumulates and results in a noticeable difference. As the Earth spins, this ellipsis of water stays aligned with the moon, so the location of the two bulges changes throughout the day. It is these bulges of water that are the high tides, and oppositely, the low tides are at a 90-degree angle from this. It takes the Earth one day to complete one rotation, so in that time, any given place on the Earth experiences each point along the ellipses. This results in two high tides and two low tides in the course of a day, or tidal cycle. This is referred to as a semi-diurnal tidal cycle. If the Earth was covered with 100% water, then there would only be semi-diurnal tides. However, the continents can block and affect the tidal patterns. This can result in diurnal tides, which is just one high tide and one low tide per tidal cycle. There are also mixed tides, which is a mix of semi-diurnal and diurnal tides. As well as affecting the tidal patterns, the continents and geography of the coastline can also affect the average tidal height. A tidal cycle is not exactly equal to one day. The moon also moves around the Earth, which results in the tidal cycle lasting a little bit longer than a day. A tidal cycle is 24 hours and 50 minutes long. This means that each high tide is 50 minutes later than it was the previous day. Since it takes approximately 1 month for the moon to orbit around the Earth, there are also monthly patterns in the tidal cycle. This is when the gravitational effect of the sun is the most noticeable. When the sun, moon, and Earth are all aligned, a new moon or full moon are visible. During these times, the gravitational effects of the sun and the moon are additive, creating the highest high tides and the lowest low tides during the month. This is referred to as spring tides. When the sun and the moon are at a 90-degree angle from one another, relative to the Earth, their gravitational forces are in opposition. Since the moon is the dominant force, it will still be aligned with the high tides. However, the effect of the sun's gravitational force will result in the lowest high tides and the highest low tides of the month, meaning the tides are less extreme. This is referred to as neap tides. Neap tides and spring tides each occur twice in a lunar cycle, with the four quarters of the moon. In conclusion, it is the movements and gravitational forces of the Earth, moon, and sun all relative to one another that causes the tidal patterns. And that is how the tides work. I bet it is way more astrophysics than you ever expected from me, but if you have any questions, please leave them down below. As always, remember to like and subscribe to see more. Until next time, I will see you later.